are.
Cameron, we were at a mobile home park earlier today that was hit very hard by this storm. We're talking about homes being leveled, others that looked like they were just blown apart. We saw a lot of people out there in that community that were walking around taking a look at the damage, and they seemed to be just dazed at what they were seeing, like they couldn't even believe their eyes. And we also talked to one man who actually invited his neighbors over to his home to ride out the storm, and it's very likely he saved their lives.
I don't understand.
It's been almost 24 hours since strong storms ripped through John Parsons' neighborhood, and he is still no closer to forgetting those few moments that seemed like forever.
It sounded like I heard a train coming for about 10 minutes. It's like the leaves quit blowing. And then all of a sudden, the wind picked up to 250 miles an hour. That's what it felt like.
Parsons knew whatever was coming was not going to be good, so he brought his next-door neighbor's boyfriend and daughter into his home and, along with his girlfriend, took cover.
We all piled in the bathtub, laid on top of each other. She was just screaming and hollering and hysterical and didn't know what to think.
And when it was finally safe to come out, this is what he found.
And this tree come through here and it sounded just like an earthquake. It made the whole ground vibrate.
Outside, the storm's power was evident. Trees ripped from the ground, insulation soaking wet and clinging to branches, memories scattered everywhere. Then there was his neighbor's home, ripped to shreds.
This is bad.
Amanda Owens' family lives next to Parson. Her sister was one of those people in the bathtub.
I was shocked. Like, I couldn't believe Mother Nature could do this.
While each of these neighbors is thankful they're safe, they're still wondering what comes next.
I mean, everything I worked for in the last 4.5 years is gone. There's nothing I can do but just go on.